Are. I would, but you know, it's too little. And the antlers are too big. Because I had a big head. Actually, I have a bunch of different kinds of antlers. I have a stupid amount of antlers. Not Halloween, Christmas antlers. Because once upon a time ago, in a land far, far away from you at least, I used to do photography. And one time I photographed this whole family, and it was wintertime and it was close to Christmas. They wanted Christmas photographs. So I had them meet me at a playground. It was really cool because there were the grandparents. Hi, Mickey. The grandparents, the grandkids, and then the kids too. So the kids, who were adults and they had their own kids, they were all like hoity-toity and really like a bunch of stick in the muds. They were not really any fun. And so, about the antlers, I brought antlers for the kids to wear. I also brought them cupcakes and a bunch of other stupid things. I never made much money as a photographer because I always spent too much on props that I would give to clients. Except the antlers. They didn't want the antlers. I kept some of the antlers. But yeah, so I did a photo shoot and it was a family and it was really cool because I had them meet me at a playground and I had the adults play on the different things like the swings and the seesaws and all these different things. I made the adults play on these things. And it was really, really cool because I don't think that they remembered how fun that was, how fun it was to be a kid, you know? So it was really cool to watch them go from like these very hoity-toity, I'm too cool to have fun or do
Wait
anything
up, wait up.
cool.
Can I get you to sing a Christmas song? Your
Can I, Porky
choice.
Penguin? Can I sing a Christmas song? I haven't sang anything yet. So I can. It will probably be not very pretty, but I can sing you a Christmas song for your sib. But anyway, it was a really fun photo shoot, and I got some really cute pictures of them too. It was adorable. It was adorable. My nose is running. Love winter time. Hi, Jimmy Jam. Oh, shucks. You are so pretty too. I don't know what you look like, but I know your heart, sort of, little. You are pretty. Okay, let's see. Top Christmas songs. Something easy. Fingers are frozen. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. In your... What is all that noise? Somebody wrapping presents? Hi, Beastie. Thank you. It looks all right. Well, I don't know what to play. Maybe rocking around the Christmas tree? How about that one? It's gonna be bad though. Everything I sing is gonna be bad until I warm up. Just a heads up. It's not gonna be pretty. Barbie girl. Well, I mean, not really a Christmas song, but maybe if it was an elf singing a Christmas song. Or maybe if it was an elf singing a song. An elf would choose to sing I'm a Barbie girl. So I don't have to hear all the usual happy stuff, but the happy stuff is awesome. I love the happy stuff. No, please don't. I'm a Barbie girl in a Barbie world made of plastic. It's fantastic. Christmas. Christmas is like less than a week away. Well, that's too bad, Shifty. You've come to the wrong place then. Because, you know, obviously I love Christmas. Look at everything around me. No, requests are not active. The only reason I'm singing a Christmas song is because Quirky Penguin resubbed. So, bribed me. I got bribed. Normally, I can't even be bribed. So, because it's just so bad. Like, once I warm up my voice, bah humbug. I know, Shifty, I'm very sorry, but I love Christmas, okay? I love it. It's my favorite. Actually, I think that I could design people's Christmas trees for many, because I think I'm pretty good at it, if I do say so myself.
Rocking around the Christmas tree at the Christmas party, y'all. And mistletoe hung where you can see. Every couple wants to stop. And rocking around the Christmas tree, let the Christmas spirit ring.
Of the song, of that song, song request. I don't know the song called Song Request. I wish I did, because then there would be one more song on my set list. I got nothing. Diego, thank you so much for the follow. We actually don't have the queue open yet. I have to warm up my voice first, which takes a little bit of time, not too long. Hi, Cranky Ray. Hello. How's it going? That was nice. Thank you, Lumen. You're very welcome. You should ask me to sing it again later when I have warmed up. Oh, the coughing part? Well, that's that's just something that I do a lot, especially when I'm warming up. Hi, Dave. Hello. On Instagram the other day, it was white and it has skulls and bats and spiders and coffins. Now, I don't normally like white trees. I think black ones are better, but I think it was cool. That sounds actually really, really cool. You need some Ricola. Actually, I took some Mucinex a while ago, so I should be okay here in a few minutes. Let's give it a minute. I literally took it like right before I sat down, so, you know, it doesn't work that fast. But it's 24-hour Mucinex, so hopefully it'll stop my nose, keep my nose from running the whole time I'm streaming.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that sounds like a really cool tree, Shifty. Robot would like that. Was it shaped like a Christmas tree? You quit? You had your last one September the 21st? Oh, dang. I was supposed to quit on October the 1st. Well, I did for like 3 days, and I cried, and I cried, and I cried, and I cried, and I cried. And I mean, I literally, we just sat on the floor in the kitchen and just cried for 3 days straight until Robot was like, okay, fine. I'll take you. I'll take you out. Let's go. And I'm like, no, I'm okay. He's like, come on. I'm like, no, I'm fine. Yeah, I'm a toddler. Good strategy. I know, right? It works. It works. How are you, Dave? How's it going today? What song was it? My 30th was on the 19th. I did promise myself I would quit when I turned 30. I promised myself I would quit when I turned 30 also. Actually, I promised myself I would quit when I was 25. And then I promised myself again that I would quit when I was 30. And then I never promised myself I would quit again. But I did pick a day. It came and went. Just About Over You. It's a country song. Who performs it? It was shaped like a normal tree. Oh, okay. Me and Robot had talked about, like, a tree for Halloween. You know, like, how come there's not a tree for Halloween, really? But we didn't really want to get something that looked like a Christmas tree, you know, because it would be the shape of a Christmas tree. So I was kind of wondering if it was, like, a Halloween tree, you know, like a spooky, leafless, you know, tree that's, like, got cool curves to, I don't know. You know what spooky old trees are supposed to look like, right? With no leaves. Actually, Heartsick, send it to me in a whisper. I can't listen to it right this minute, but I will listen to it later. I won't be able to remember it if it's just in the chat, but if you send it to me in a whisper, I'll totally check it out. I do take song requests, but only after I've warmed up my voice. So let me warm up my voice a little bit, and then we will open up the queue. And then, like, I have songs that I sing that are in my set list, so. So, let's do something that's not. I'll do that. That song that was just an example a while ago. Take Me to the Night We Met. This song's really, really cool. It was in that that show, like 13 Reasons or 13 something, about the girl who commits suicide. It was on Netflix. People had a conniption fit about it. This was from the dance scene in that show. Or at least this song was, I guess it's not from that, but it was used in that, and it was so good. And so I had to look it up and learn it because it's such a cool song. Do you have Twitter? Do you follow me on Twitter? You can send it to me in a whisper on Twitter.
I'm not the only traveler searching for a trail to follow again. Take me to the night we met.
Felicity, hi. I haven't seen you in forever. How are you doing? Please don't make me rap. I love you, Felicity. Felicity a follow. She's one of my old, not oldest, but longest running friendships here on Twitch. I've known her for literally ever, so many years, over half a decade now, I think.
Had all been most of you. Some and now none of you.
What's wrong with walking into stuff? I do it all the time. Just don't do it. It's hard not to if you're clumsy. I mean, some people just look. I try to walk a straight line, okay? And then for some reason, I tilt this way too much or I tilt this way too much. And before I know it, there's the side of the couch and I'm breaking my toes or there's a doorway. And I thought that I was able to gauge exactly where this doorway was. I thought I was going to make it, you know, but I don't. I tilt too far one way or the other and I run right into it. I can't help it. You just don't know. Look, you don't understand. Felicity, what were you doing on your stream today? Were you playing a game or were you playing music? Felicity is a musician and a singer. She's got a really pretty voice. Almost tripped over just before trying to throw something out. Is it the blonde hair? I mean, maybe. Possibly. I don't know. All right, something easy. She was singing Christmas music. She was. Oh. Yeah, I really like Felicity. She's just such a sweet person. And, you know, she's really good at rapping. And I can't tell you how many times I have raided her. And then when she asked for the raid song, I have demanded that she rap because she's so good at it. So I'm very happy that she didn't try to get me back today. She is a rap god. I don't know how she does it, but she does. And then she's always like apologizing for the language that she's using when she's rapping. And I'm like, this is what we asked for. Yeah, she's awesome. Well, good luck getting her to rap. It's not easy. I would suggest throwing her a pile of money and then see if she'll do it. Because then she can't say no, right? I can say no, though, so don't even think about it. Nobody think about it. It's not going to happen. Nope. Nope. Brightness settings. That could be my lights. I moved my lights a little bit, and I mean, also my shirt is light, and the light happens to be pointed at my shirt, so that's one of the reasons why. If I'm blinding you, I'm sorry. Look, I shine bright like a diamond today in pink. It's not my fault. I can't help it. I'm a star. No, I'm just kidding. Always wear shades while watching the stream. Hey, you bite me. Okay, let's do a Christmas song. I only wrap up leftovers that I cook. I'll have you know I cook the food in the first place. All right, let's do Is That You, Santa Claus? Hi, Mickey. Hey, Mickey, you're so fine. You're so fine. You blow my mind. Hey, Mickey. Sorry, my allergies are crazy.
Under the door, and winds are howling, or could that be? 'cause I know that you're there. We don't believe in no goblins today, but I can't explain why I'm shaking this way. Now I can see old Santa through the keyhole, and I'll get to the cause. One peek and I'll be there.
Costco cinnamon rolls are dangerous. I thought I'd warm those up and maybe have one or two if nobody else wants anymore. I have to eat them so they don't go bad, right? I would, but they're cinnamon and I'm allergic to cinnamon. Hi, Bright Star. Hello, how are you doing? Thank you so much for the follow. Does your smile work? Well, no, I have found that my evil stare works a lot better than smiling if I want something real bad. Yeah, exactly. Prince Adam knows. Yeah, it's the look, you know, it's the evil eye. That's how I get stuff if I really 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 want stuff. But mostly I use that if he does something that I'm very unhappy about, then I might give the evil eye. You've given me the evil stare. That's because you keep trying to tell people that I killed my goat, and I didn't kill my goat. My goat's perfectly fine. Yeah, I have a goat. Things are getting harder for my mom with Christmas coming closer without my stepdad around. Aw, Mickey. 20 years as of Tuesday. Wait. What? 20 years as of... What do you mean 20 years as of Tuesday? All right, so I do sit on the kitchen floor and cry for 3 days straight if I really want something. But in my defense, I'm not a big crier, so it's pretty unusual to see me crying, which means that it's going to definitely be more effective if I'm not, you know, if I never, ever, 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 ever cry. And then I suddenly decide I'm going to cry for 3 days. I mean, that makes everybody go, oh my God, are you okay? Is everything okay? Because it's just so unusual for me to cry. My 20th anniversary is on Tuesday. Oh my gosh. Hi, Gat. Well, okay. I have cried on stream. Well, not really on stream. I took a break and cried twice since I started streaming I've been streaming for like 6 years. So one time was because my dog had died that day and I shouldn't have streamed, but I decided to stream anyway. I thought it would take my mind off of it. But it didn't. It just made me sadder. I don't know. It was just really hard to do. And then the other time was because my mod Octopus, I was drinking wine and he told, while I was streaming, and he told me that that he wasn't going to be able to hang out in the stream that much anymore because he had, like, picked up another job or something. And because I was drinking, I took that to mean he was never coming back. And I got very emotional, and I had to take a break so I could cry, which was weird, but that happened. Other than that, I think I've been pretty successful at not crying on stream. It's a rough event to lose a pet. Yeah, and it's not a good idea to try to sing to people when you lose a pet either. Crying and... Why are you laughing? Crying and singing, they're not, it's not a conducive combination there. Robot tells me you cry over me. Yeah, but you lie, so I can't believe a word you say. Okay, what else? What else should I sing? I'm not used to having this many people in here while I'm warming up, so I'm nervous. If I told her I couldn't hang out anymore, yes, I would. You guys stop it. Stop trying to make me get upset and cry. It's not going to work because I know you're liars. Santa baby? Okay. Santa baby. I do love Santa baby. How to help my mom? I would say distraction would probably be the best way to help your mom, Mickey. Distraction. Because if you're busy doing things and, well, if you're just very distracted, it's harder to have time to be sad about something, you know? Put some onions in front of the lemon. No, stop it. Oh, hi, Millie. Hello, how are you doing? Going through a breakup at the gym. Well, I did end up losing weight. From crying? Or from the exercising? Or were you exercising and crying at the same time? So that's very strange. Santa baby. Let's hold off on Santa baby. It's a little high in my register, and I need to do some more singing before I do Santa baby. Also, I gotta warm up my fingers too. It's a lot of chord changes and stuff. 15 songs on the song list that have the word cry in the title. There are? Are you guys gonna request a bunch of new new hair? Very nice. So you got a commercial. Man, that sucks, Millie. I'm sorry. Well, I did cut my hair the other day because I'm trying to grow it long and it just needed a haircut really bad. All right, let's see. I'm gonna look up top songs about crying. These will not prompt me to cry. Just letting you guys know. I will not be crying. I'll sing Big Girls Don't Cry. No, I'm just kidding. Big Girls Don't Cry. There's no way I could sing a Frankie Valli song right now. How about When Doves Cry? They go coo, coo. That's what they do when they cry. They don't sound like actual crying. I am trying to, yeah, I'm going to try to grow my hair long again. I'm not kind to my hair, and I need to start taking better care of it, so. When Lemons Cry. I don't know that one. Maybe I'll cry happy tears. I mean, that doesn't happen either. It's hard for me to be anything but the way that I am. You know how I'm just kind of flat all the time? I mean, I don't think I'm singing flat, but you know, like when I talk, I'm monotone and I'm not very excitable and I'm like this all the time, like very even. My mood is just like this almost all the time. By Jay-Z. I don't know that one. Plateau Lemon. Yeah, basically that's me all the time. So crying is just, it's too far on the spectrum of emotion, and you know what I mean? It's hard for, like, if I won the lottery right now, I would be like, oh cool, I don't think I, it would just be really difficult for me. You're easily excitable. I am? I don't think so. I don't think you guys know me at all. Okay.
Dig, if you will, the picture.
Let me try that again with reverb this time. I don't have enough energy to cry. There you go. If we get on the topic of, usually I'm mad. Usually if I'm reacting in that way, Jerry, have you ever noticed? It's because I'm super mad. Like if somebody comes in and tells me I'm not, like what I do is of no value or something, then oh man. Hi Jerry, how are you?
Dig if you will. You and I engaged in a kiss. The sweat of your body covers me. Can you, my darling, can you picture this?
Well, let's see. I've known Robot for about 25 years. I've seen him actually cry one time. I saw him almost cry another time, so no.
If you can, a courtyard, an ocean of vines of bloom, an animal stride, curious poses, they feel the heat between me and you. And how can you just leave me standing alone in a world that's so cold? Just like my father, too bold. Maybe you're just like my mother, 'cause she's never satisfied. And why do we scream at each other? And this is what it sounds like when doves cry.
Mac, thank you so much for the donation. I appreciate it. What it is, we both have very rough lives and we are a little desensitized. I think that's what it is.
And touch, if you will, my stomach and feel how it trembles inside. And you've got the butterflies all tied up. Don't make me chase you, 'cause even doves have. Just too demanding. Maybe I'm just like my father, too bold. And maybe you're just like my mother, 'cause she's never satisfied. And why do we scream at each other? And this is what it sounds like when doves cry.
I'm glad you guys think so. I am a Kentucky Colonel. I'm actually very proud of that. I don't know if you guys have noticed. I'm very proud of being a Kentucky Colonel because I worked really hard for it. Hey, Joe. How's it going? Thank you so much for the follow. Military people and badasses cry alone. I just it takes a lot. I'll tell you what will make me cry. When I see videos of people who have been separated for a long time and they are reunited. And this can be like when kids are reunited with their parents who are serving overseas or something. Or it could even be like a pet who, you know, hasn't seen their owner for a long time or what. It doesn't really, people or animals or whatever being reunited, now that makes me cry. So I'm not ex-military, no. No. When I say Kentucky Colonel, what I mean by that, I went a read up about it when I found out you were. Oh, yeah. Okay. So in Kentucky, which is where I'm from, you can be nominated to be something called a Kentucky Colonel. Have you guys ever heard of Colonel Sanders or Kentucky Fried Chicken? They call him Colonel Sanders because he was a Kentucky Colonel too. I can technically be introduced as a Kentucky Colonel if I go somewhere. But you have to, in order to become a Kentucky Colonel, you're technically supposed to do some kind of humanitarian work for people in Kentucky in order to become a Kentucky Colonel. And to get the award, you have to be nominated by somebody who is already a Kentucky Colonel. And also, the governor signs it and you get a certificate and it's pretty cool. You can get box seats, specialty seats at the Kentucky Derby and stuff like that. But I got it because I spent many years working with the military and helping military families, people who, because a lot of people would come back from overseas and they would have post-traumatic stress disorder or traumatic brain injuries because they had served a lot of tours over there or had had injuries or, you know, and there were so many people, there have been so many troops coming through the military and not really getting the help that they needed when they got out. Cause you need some kind of you need some, because of the horrific things that you're seeing when you're in, let me make me a colonel. I could, but you got to work for it. I can't just give it to, I could give it to you, but I can nominate you. That's all I can do. I can't choose to make somebody Kentucky Colonel. I can nominate somebody though. You can. Yeah. For some weird reason, celebrities get the title as Kentucky Colonels all the time. There's so many famous people who are Kentucky Colonels and it's not even fair because most of them haven't done any humanitarian work to get the honor of being a Kentucky Colonel. You know what I mean? It's not fair, but it's whatever. I worked for it. Robot's a Kentucky Colonel also, so he worked for it too. But anyway, so a lot of people, you know, they'll get out of the military from one of the tours that they're doing and they'll have seen things that were traumatic and they needed psychological help when they got out. And a lot of them didn't get help and they would be sent right back in there. And, you know, so a lot of people who've come out of the military haven't been able to work or anything because they've just been struggling internally, you know. So what I did to get that award was help to raise money for those families in particular, so that they wouldn't have to worry about, you know, how they would get the money to pay their electric bill or stay in their houses and, you know what I mean, rent and cars and all that good stuff. So that's what I did forever, for many, many years. Not just with one, company, but with a bunch of different companies. So there were things I did a lot of things for also the animals and stuff that would be left over there and some of the animals that would be brought back and just all kinds of stuff. Lots of stuff like that. No, don't salute me because I never served in the military. I'm not military at all. That's just something that I did for a long time, for years. And I just kind of quit doing it because I did it for a really long time. And I got sick of making graphics. This is so stupid, but I really got tired of making graphics that were just the American flag over and over and over and over and over and over again for years. And I was like, I just can't. I need to go do something different for a little while. You get saluted because you are a woman. What? You guys just, you know, bow as I walk through past. That'll be good enough. Yeah, I think celebrities often get that award for that reason. In Canada, anyway. Really? Women get saluted in Canada? Oh, that's adorable. That's so cute. I love it. I love it. Okay, let's sing a song. Another song. Can you please curtsy? Just roll out a red carpet. That's what I want. Someplace. Because you know what? If you're wearing heels and you're walking through grass and your heels just get stuck in the mud. They just go, they sink, you know, you're like this. Your foot's like this. And then it sinks down into the dirt, you know. And just somebody roll out a carpet for me and that I can walk on. If it's raining. Or the ground's wet. Or there's a lot of grass. That's good. That's all I need. Thanks. Thanks. You guys are swell. Thanks. Hi, James. Hello. How goes the day? I would, but you never... I'll carry you. You will. Oh, I can't let you do that. Because I can walk myself. That's true. I never leave Kentucky. I can't afford to leave Kentucky. It's too expensive. Everywhere on the planet is so expensive. I don't know why. Okay, how about I'm gonna sing Bluebird by Miranda Lambert. We'll open up the queue here in a few minutes, you guys. And then I'll sing the songs that you guys want me to sing instead of the ones I want to sing. You carry her, I'll carry Robot. Robot would probably would let you carry. I know you can, but hills. I don't know, man. Not all the songs. Not this song. I don't think this song is about crying.
And the bluebird. And if the house just keeps on winning, I've got a wild card up my sleeve. And if love keeps giving me limits, I'll just mix them in my drink. And if the whole wide world stops singing and all the stars go dark, keep a light on in my soul, keep a bluebird in my heart, keep a light on in my soul.
Right. I'm a nice person. I'm also very dangerous. Too many songs on the list. Is that why hearts flutter? Yes. Yes. Hi, Yobo. How's it going? I haven't really warmed up yet. We need more cowbells. We do need more cowbells.
All our times have come. And here, but now they're gone. Seasons don't fear. The sun or the rain, so come on, baby. Take my hand, we'll be able to fly. Baby, I'm your nana. We can be like they are.
Get it, cowbell? Get it. No. No percussion. The AC at home isn't doing a bad job. The AC outside of my house isn't doing a bad job either. Man, it's cold. It's like freezing cold. I don't like it. It's too cold for me. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and take my first break. And then we'll open up the queue while I'm on my break. And you guys can go ahead and start picking songs. And Mac, you get first dibs on songs, okay? And Quirky, if you would like to put another song in, like if you like would like to pick a Christmas song, just you guys... Do me a solid and don't pick anything super crazy hard to sing yet, because I talked more than sang. No crying on break. I'm only going to cry if I think you're leaving, Dave. As long as you don't leave, I won't cry. Santa baby. I might be ready for Santa baby. You could also lower the key. Well, I actually play my own chord. Well, I don't know. Probably, I don't think I could change the key. Yeah, I think that would be difficult. On that song, it would be difficult to change the key on it. But I might be able to sing it. We'll see. We'll see. I'll be right back, you guys. What's Daybot's favorite? Who's Daybot? Nightbot? Are you talking about Nightbot? I don't know this Daybot you speak of. Robot's favorite music? He does, well, he's kind of like me. He's really all over the place as far as his interest in music goes. I would say probably Western swing. You know, like Bob Wills. That kind of stuff. Like what cowboys played around campfires. That stuff. Not country music, but Western swing. Totally different. Completely different. I would say that's what he likes to listen to a lot, but I don't know. He's just all over the board when it comes to music. Between the two of us, it's a pretty big list of songs, you know what I'm saying? Asleep at the Wheel? I don't know what that is, but he probably would. Aw, Kai, thank you so much for the $35 donation. I appreciate it. Thank you. Oh, internal, thank you for the follow. That is very kind of you, Kai. I really appreciate it. Let me know what I can sing for you for your donation. So nice. Merry Christmas to you too, Kai. Santa Baby was what I was going to play for Quirky Penguin. I can't promise it will be good, but it will be a song. So that's something. You don't get that in every stream. Unless you only watch music streamers, then you get that in every stream. Okay. My earbuds are untangled. Let's see if I can get them on my head. There's one down, one to go. Can she do it? Yes, she can. At least this time.
Santa baby, slip a sable under the tree for me. I've been an awful good girl, Santa baby, and hurry down the chimney tonight. Santa baby, a 54 convertible to light blue. I'll wait up for you, dear Santa baby, and hurry down the chimney tonight. Next year I could be just as good if you'll check off my Christmas list. Santa baby, I want a yacht, and really that's not a lot. I've been an angel all year, Santa baby, and hurry down the chimney tonight. To mention one little thing, a ring. to baby and hurry down the chimney tonight. Come and trim my Christmas tree with some decorations bought at Tiffany's. I really do believe in.
It's a bit confusing. I have four music streams open. Do you like take turns muting them, or are you listening to all four at the same time? All right, Frosty the Snowman is the next one because Mac made a donation too. Blue Christmas. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Okay, let me bump these songs up. Hold on a second, you guys. I'll have a blue. Hey Kai, will you sing backup? I need backup vocals for Blue Christmas. Frosty the Snowman. Frosty the Snowman is very sad. That part where he melts. I mean, I hate to spoil it for you guys, but it's very sad, I think, in my opinion. I want you to sing.
Thump, 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 look at Frosty.
James, thank you so much for the follow. You are not the worst mod ever. Those people who have never been to my stream again after I made the mod, those are the worst mods ever. That stops rolling. It did. Were you falling asleep, Cranky Ray? Not supposed to fall asleep. Okay. Let me move Lemon's Choice up underneath of Blue Christmas. Trey, thank you so much for the 10 gift subs. I really, really, really appreciate it. I do. I sure do. Okay, Blue Christmas. Do you want me to pick a Christmas song or do you want me to pick any song? Will any song do or would you rather have a Christmas song? I'll have a blue Christmas without you. I'll be so blue just thinking about you. Decorations of red on a Christmas tree won't be the same, dear, if you're not here with me. And when those blue snowflakes start falling, that's when those blue memories start calling. You'll be doing all right with your Christmas white, but I'll have a blue Christmas. What you're singing, Kai. I hear it in my head. Thank you so much for the background vocals, because that was lovely. I thought that you did a great job, Kai. I really liked it. It's perfect. It's exactly what I was looking for. Super. You're welcome. Thank you so much for the biddies. Thank you. All right. Let's see. What song will I sing? Trey, how about I know just the song. I got it. Hold on. I almost have it. I was gonna change the key, but I don't think so.
mentions the word addiction. Certain company. She tells you she's an orphan after you meet her family. Black as night now, pulls those shades down tight. Give you a smile when the pain comes. Pain's gonna make everything alright. She talks to cross around her neck. Here comes from a little boy across from someone she's met. Not yet. She talks to angels. Says they call her. Thank you.
It took me a second because every time you come in, DJ, I always think that you're telling a true story. Every single time I get tricked every single time. I know you love that song, Trey. I know you love that song. That's why I played it. Black Crows pay me $500 to steal a baby turtle from the brothers from Oasis hotel room during the 1998 Brotherly Love Tour. Isn't that an ironic name? She's off her meds. But then they stiffed me and didn't let me back on the bus, so I had to thumb my way home from Birmingham, North Dakota. There's a Birmingham in North Dakota? I didn't know that. Yeah, but what happened to the turtle? That's a good question. $500 was a ton of money to me in 1998. I'd like the paint off of your house for $100 today. I'd lick the paint off of your house for $100 today. Oh, okay. I was like, what? You're going to buy the paint on my house for $100? I mean, I think it's going to cost me more to repaint the house if I give you the paint on my house. Named him Morning Glory after this, or like the song. Do I play Morning Glory? Is that a song or is that just an album? I know the album's called What's the Story, Morning Glory. Is there a song called Morning Glory? Hold on. Lead poisoning. Doesn't sound like a good name for a turtle. Well, you said that Parker wasn't a good name for a goat, too, so I don't know. Oh. Named him that for two reasons, but we are in mixed company. Anyway, they're nice guys. What was that song just now? Wait, what? What do you mean, what was... I just sang the song Morning Glory. What? Are you suffering from lead poisoning? Is there some arsenic in your hat? I mean, that's why hatters were mad. They had poisonous hats. You don't know the song, but you met the Gallagher brothers. I feel like this is all a lie. I'm just an ass. There's a joke in there somewhere. I just can't find it. Yobo, I need help. Help me come up with a joke for that. Something about arsenic. The cake is a lie. What? All right. James, you have put in the song Somewhere Only We Know, which is a very good song. And internal, you put Long As I Can See the Light. That's actually probably my favorite Creedence song is that song. Because I don't feel like a lot of people know it, but they should because it's so good. It's not like the most famous song of Creedence. You know what I mean? It's not like Fortunate Son or something, but it's like, I don't know. I like it. Okay, Somewhere Only We Know. Portal, a video game. Yeah, because you can be in like two places at once, right? In Portal? Can't half of your body be in one part of the game and the other half of your... I don't know. I've never played Portal. I've seen other people play it, though. Change the key of this.
Walked across an empty land, knew the pathway like the back of my hand, and I felt the earth beneath my feet, sat by the river, and it made me complete. Simple thing, where have you gone? Getting old and I need something to rely on. So tell me when you're gonna let me in. Getting tired, need somewhere to begin. Came across a fallen tree. I felt the branches of it looking at me. Is this the place we used to love? Is this the place that I've been dreaming of? Simple thing, where have you gone? I'm getting old and I need something to rely on. So tell me when you're gonna let me in. Getting tired and I need somewhere to begin. If you have a minute, why don't we go talk about it somewhere only we know. This could be the end of everything. So why don't we go somewhere only we know? Somewhere only we know. Sympathy, where have you gone? I'm getting old and I need something to rely on. So tell me when you're gonna let me in. I'm getting tired and I need somewhere to begin. And if you have a minute, why don't we go talk about it somewhere only we know. This could be the end of everything. So why don't we go? Why don't we go?
Cry about it. I'm just kidding. Meet Virginia. It sounds really familiar. I don't know if I know what that is though. We should riot. Yeah, you should. Go ahead and try. If you guys show up at my house, I would have a heart attack. That would scare me so bad. I suggest trashing your room. No, no, no. I need this room. You don't understand. You don't know. You don't know. You don't know. It sounds really familiar, but I don't know. I don't know what that is. Do I have my phone? Sorry. Penguin gets it. Meet Virginia. It sounds really familiar. I might know what it is. It doesn't ring a bell right now. Oh, DJ, thank you so much for gifting a sub to D. Dr. Meyer. That'd be really cool if we could add a new song to the set list. I'm always down for that. Virginia. I don't know. Watch me not know it at all. Oh, it's a train song? Okay, hold on. Let me mute the microphone. I'm more upset now. Why are you what? Hold on. Let me mute the mic. Nope, never heard it. Weird. can't say it rings a bell. Don't recognize it. Nobody's gonna call bullshit. I guess I should give you guys an opportunity since there's a delay. Let me Google the chords real quick. Hold on just a second, internal. I know you have a song in there. Bullshit. I was singing it. They actually had three songs that were big hit songs. This is the lesser of the three. Because they had that one where he talks about his hairy chest. It's super gross. And then they had Drops of Jupiter. She doesn't own a dress. Hair is always a mess. Catch her still and she won't confess. She's beautiful. Smokes a pack a day, way past me, but anyway. Okay, stay with me here. She doesn't own a dress. Hair is always a mess. You catch her still and she won't confess. She's beautiful. She smokes a pack a day. But way past me, but anyway. Doesn't care a thing about that, hey. She thinks I'm beautiful. Surprises, wears high heels while she's exercising. Ain't that beautiful? Me, Virginia. Well, she wants to be the queen, and she thinks about her scenes. Pulls her like. Oh, Okay, let's not add. Don't add this. Please, whatever you do, don't add that. That's terrible. DJ, thank you so much for gifting a sub to TJ. This is not going to be confusing for me at all. Not even a little bit. All right, let's do Long As I Can See the Light. The timing on that song is a pain in the ass. It's real weird, and I was struggling. Oh, hi, watching. Very awkward. I mean, I'm glad that there's no camera in my bathroom. Long as I can see the light. Thank you for the follow, though. Worst gift ever. What? They came out weird. I know, right? That's how I feel.
Put a candle in the window, 'cause I feel I've gotta move. Though I'm going, I'll be coming home soon. Long as I can see the light. Pack my bag and let's keep moving, 'cause I'm bound to drift away.
Yes, I do, but from my set list. So most of the songs that I play are covers, but I only accept songs from my list of songs. Internal, thank you so much for the subscription. I really, really, really appreciate it. Let me know if there's another song I can sing for you, whatever you would like to hear. Cranky Ray, thank you so much for the 100 biddies. my goodness, is there a hype train happening? Yes. Yes, Merry Christmas to me. And Merry Christmas to you. I mean, Merry Christmas to you guys. That's what I meant to say. Thank you so much for the hype train. I gotta get some more hot coffee. Hot coffee. Let's do another song by CCR. Let's do Proud Mary. Lost on You. I don't think that I know that song. So I don't think that one's on my set list. Wait, the song is called G? I definitely don't know that song then. Sing a little higher. Bippity. Hi, Bippity. Okay.
Rolling. on a river.
Man, that chord progression is bugging me. I changed the key, so now I'm like, what's a D sharp? Watching, thank you so much for subscribing to my channel. I appreciate it. Yeah, definitely no Call Me Maybe. Thank you guys so much for the hype train, too. So nice. Hold on, I gotta check this chord progression. It's bugging me. What is that? Hold on, I gotta figure out. Do I need that chord? Well, I mean, I guess I could play that on the 6th fret. You guys are like, what is this mad woman talking about? Trust me, it's important. I'm so sorry to hear that, Trey. If you guys are wondering, Trey is he is ex-military, so which is really, really, I mean, that sucks so much because as somebody, I mean, I've never been in the military, but I know that that happens like way too much, you know. I'm going to go now. Aw. Well, Trey, if you need anybody to talk to, just, you know, I'm around if you need somebody to talk to, because I know that's got to be rough. But, yeah, I mean, it's a traumatic experience, so it's just hard, you know. But, Trey, thank you so much for everything that you do for me. I mean it. But if you need anybody to talk to, I'm around. I'm here. Amazing. For a random guy to talk to. Okay, let me see what's in the queue. Oh, we just have Call Me Maybe. I really like this song. I think Carly Rae, what's her name? Jepsen. She's so cute. She's adorable. Hi, Wyatt. Hello, how are you doing? How goes the day? Call Me Maybe. I love One Headlight. I love that song. Hold on. Let me do One Headlight first for Internal, who also subscribed a few minutes ago. Thank you guys so much for that hype train, by the way. Thank you. I literally pay my rent with the hype trains. I couldn't live without them. You don't even know how much they matter. You know, they really, really, really help me in the biggest way, which is just to keep a roof over my head. So, thank you guys. Okay, we're going to do One Headlight first. And then we'll do Your Song next. I have them both right here. I have Call Me Maybe open already, so. I really, really, really need to take a break. I wonder if you guys would be okay with that. How would you guys feel if I took a break? How about this? Internal, how do you feel about it? Because I'm about to play your song. Are you okay with me taking a break real quick? I just wanted to make sure, because I would hate for, like, what if you have somewhere you got to be, you know? Okay, I'll be right back, you guys. Hopefully you won't leave. Hopefully you'll stay here. That would be awesome. That'd be so cool. I was just thinking of watching how I thought my first impressions were that you were a troll. Not just because of your name, but also because of your song request. I'd never heard it before. And I thought, is this one of those requests? Am I getting one of those requests? I live in Kentucky, so it's kind of like that. My Be Right Back screen is kind of like that in Kentucky. Well, it's just like that in Kentucky in the summertime. I really should change it since it's the middle of winter, but I mean, I can tell, yeah, you are a legitimate person. It wasn't until you scrubbed and you scrubbed. Until you subbed. I don't know if you scrub or not. It was. I don't want no scrub. Scrub is a guy that can't get no love from me. Once you subbed and requested a song that definitely was a real song, and I was like, oh, okay, this is a real person. Trolls don't do those things. I live in Australia. A lot of people who watch my stream happen to live in Australia. No, thank you. Aw. Don't you want to go chasing some waterfalls, though?
So long ago, I don't remember when. That's when they say I lost my only friend. They said she died easy of a broken heart disease. As I listen to the cemetery trees. She always had a pretty face, and I wonder why she hung around this place. She said it's cold, feels like Independence Day, and I can't break away from this parade. There's gotta be an opening somewhere here in front of me, and through this maze of ugliness and greed. I've seen the sun up ahead at the county line bridge, saying all is good and nothing else is dead. Run until she's out of breath. She ran until there's nothing left. She hit the end, it's just her window ledge. And hey, come on, try a little. Nothing is forever. It's gotta be something better than in the middle. Together we can drive it home with one headlight. It feels just like a beat-up truck. I turn the engine, but the engine doesn't turn. It smells of cheap wine and cigarettes. This place at all is such a mess. Sometimes I think I'd like to watch it burn. I'm so alone, and I feel just like somebody else. Man, I ain't changed, but I know I ain't the same. Somewhere here in between the city walls of dying dreams, I think her death must be killing me. And hey, 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 come on, try a little. There's nothing is forever. There's gotta be something better than in the middle. Cinderella, we put it all together, we can drive it home with one headlight.
Hi, Lucid. Hello. Can I call you Lucy? That'd be awesome. I bet I'd be the only person on the whole internet that calls you that. Can I call you Lucy? Like, and then everybody can say, oh, I love Lucy. Oh, thank you so much, Internal. I'm glad that you liked it. I really like that song. I normally don't finger pick the song, but I should have played it like 2 frets down. It was really high for me, and the only way I could like pull it off without screaming and messing up my vocal cords was to kind of play it soft like that. Normally don't play it. Normally I play it closer to like the way the song actually is, but I'm glad you liked it. Thank you. It's one at a time. So, let me take that one out. It's not one per stream, but it's one at a time in the queue. So you can only have one song in there at a time. There is a limit to how many songs you can have during a stream, but I don't know what the limit is. And I think if you're subscribed, you might not have a limit. Coffee is always a good idea. 3 for a follower, 5 for a sub. Oh, okay. I see. Trying to figure out if it's the right key.
Your stars are holding ripped jeans, skin showing, hot night winds blowing. Where you think you're going, baby? Hey, I just met you, and this is crazy. Here's my number.
Okay, that's a good key. I do request, well, for my set list. I mean, I technically do live learns also. I charge $25 for those. I don't actually particularly, even though, I mean, I can earn more money that way, I don't particularly enjoy doing live learns because it kind of just takes away. It hurts my brain. That's the truth. Hi, Shelby. Hello. How are you doing? Thank you.
Hey, Bippity, did you have a song request? And Cranky Ray, did you have a song request for that hype train a while ago?
I threw a wish in the well. Don't ask me, I'll never tell.
Hold on, let me try again.
I threw a wish in the well. Don't ask me, I'll never tell. I looked to you and it fell. And now you're in my way. Trade my soul for a wish. Pennies and dimes for a kiss. Wasn't looking for this. But now you're in my way. And your stare was holding. Ripped jeans, skin was showing. Hot night wind was blowing. Where you think you're going, baby? Hey, I just met you. And this is crazy. But here's my number. So call me maybe. It's hard to look right at you, baby. So here's my number. So call me maybe. Hey, I just met you. And this is crazy. But here's my number. So call me maybe. And all the other boys try to chase me. But here's my number. Took my time with the fall. You gave me nothing at all. But still you're in my way. I beg and borrow and steal. At first sight and it's real. I didn't know I would feel. But it's in my way. And your stare was holding. Ripped jeans, skin was showing. Hot night wind was blowing. And where you think you're going, baby? Hey, I just met you. And this is crazy. But here's my number. Call me maybe, and it's hard to look right at you lately. But here's my number, so call me maybe. Hey, I just met you, and this is crazy. But here's my number, so call me maybe. And all the other boys try to chase me. But here's my number, so call me maybe.
Down the street first. This is what Parker will do. Parker's my goat. I have a goat, and it takes the strength of 10 men to wrangle a goat. He's very strong. So this is what will happen if you put him on any kind of lead or rope or anything. First, he will run around you and knock you down with his rope. Then he will run and drag you down the street. So walking him would be just painful, you know. It would really hurts so bad. And then, you know, while you're laying there and you're completely tied up by the rope because the goat tied you up, he's going to eat your clothes right off of you and your hair and everything. Because he's a goat. He's the master at parkour. Yes, he does. Shelby, thank you so much for gifting us up to Rachel. And Brian, hi. Thank you so much for the 1,000 biddies. I appreciate it. Thank you. Yeah, my goat's name is Parker, and he is an asshole. Because he's a goat, and all goats are assholes. Ask any goat owner. They will tell you. They're assholes. I'll cut my hair off. Are you going to cut your clothes off, too? Giggity. Do the same thing to you. Oh, that's terrifying. That's really scary, Bippity. I wouldn't tell anybody. Don't tell anybody. I think Beastie, I think Bippity's talking to you. Okay. I'm going to do a song for Lucid because Lucid hasn't had a song yet. So, it's Whiskey Lullaby. It's pretty anticlimactic with just me singing it because there's no harmonies or anything. But I'll sing it anyway. I used to sing this to my daughter Evelyn when she was really little. It was like her favorite song when she was a toddler. I'd be like, this song is depressing, but okay. Sure, I'll sing it again. Oh, yeah. Well, Parker's really good. He doesn't really headbutt you. He does that to the dogs, though. He'll, like, headbutt the dogs if they get... He gets really jealous, so... If the dogs get close to me and I'm hanging out with Parker, then he'll headbutt them. Or if they get anywhere near his food, he will try to headbutt them. But he likes to play with me. He thinks it's really fun to jump up on his hind legs, and I usually jump up too. Because, in fact, I'll jump to see if I can get him to jump. Because it's super fun. He just, I don't know. It's just fun. I like my goat. I know I'm a weirdo, but I can't help it. Sing songs. You ready? You ready, BC? That's too low. Let me try again.
Watch him drink his pain away a little at a time.
Sorry. Trying to clear my throat.
But he never could get drunk enough to get her off his mind until the night. He put that bottle to his head and pulled the trigger. Finally drank away her memory. Life is short, but this time it was bigger than the strength he had to get up off his knees. And we found him with his face down in the pillow, with a note that said, I love her till I die. When we buried him beneath the willow, and the angels sang a whiskey lullaby, la 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 la, la 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 la. For years and years, she tried to hide the whiskey on her breath. She finally drank her pain away a little at a time, but she never could get drunk enough She put that bottle to her head and pulled the trigger. And finally drank away his memory. And life is short, but this time it was bigger than the strength she had to get up off her knees. And we found her with her face down in the pillow, clinging to his picture for dear life. And we laid her next to him beneath the willow, while the angels sang a whiskey lullaby. La 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 la. La 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 la. La 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 la. La 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 la.
The song is just not very good without harmonies. I sing it with my daughter sometimes when she streams with me, and it makes more sense when I do it with Leah. When I sing that song with myself, it's just, the video, think of as a video with Lemon and Parker jumping and scored with appropriate music. You should see the clothes that I'm wearing, because I'm usually wearing, I've got steel-toed duck boots that I wear, and I wear duck boots and Daisy Dukes to go out and feed my goat, because I'm from Kentucky, and this is what you wear in Kentucky. And I'm usually wearing some ridiculous coat. I have this red coat that I wear to go out to feed the goat and take care of the goat. And Robot makes so much fun of me. And he won't be seen in public with me in my big red coat. And I like my big red coat. I don't even care if it's ugly. I like it. It makes me happy. All right. I will follow you into the dark. Yeah, goats are cool. But you got to be comfortable, you know, when you're hauling giant... freaking giant bales of hay and shit. You gotta be comfortable. So, you know, I will follow you into the dark. And I live out in the middle of nowhere, so nobody really sees me. Which is good. Which is very good. Very, very often, even in the winter, yeah, because a lot of times he will rub up against me, or he'll like lean up against me or whatever, and or I'll end up having to handle him or whatever, and I don't want my clothes to get completely dirty, because it's hard to get the smell of goat off of you, so it's better just to wear shorts, that way you can like wash your legs off, you know what I mean? I do not hurt anybody. Quit saying things like that about me. People are going to think terrible things about me for the millionth time. Hi, Positively Panda. Hello, how are you doing?
Someday you will die and I'll be close behind. I'll follow you into the dark and no blinding light and tunnels to gates of white. Just our hands clasped so tight, waiting for the hint of a spark. If heaven and hell decide that they both are satisfied and illuminate the nose on their vacancy signs, if there's no one beside you, your soul embarks, and I will follow you into the dark. in Catholic school, as vicious as Roman rule, and I got my knuckles bruised by a lady in black, and I held my tongue as she told me, son, fear is the heart of love. So I never went back, and if heaven and hell decide that they both are satisfied and illuminate the nose on their vacancy signs, and if there's no one beside you and your soul embarks, then I will follow you into the dark. Seen everything to see, from Bangkok to Calgary, and the soles of your shoes are all worn down, and the time for sleep is now, but it's nothing to cry about, 'cause we'll hold each other soon. Heaven and hell decide that they both are satisfied and illuminate the nose on their vacancy signs. If there's no one beside you, your soul embarks, and I will follow you into the dark.
Yeah, they're just goat shorts. That's all. How do you explain Gort? How do you explain Gort shorts? How do you explain goat shorts? We've actually had it pretty warm here lately too. It's very weird because, like, we had those tornadoes and stuff about a week ago. It's been unseasonably warm in Kentucky, so you can totally some dorts, some bortaborts. Hey, we know somebody named Bortabort. Goddamn. Okay, Bippity, you have a song in here, so I'm going to sing your song real quick. Do you have a bunker? I do not have a bunker. I don't even have a basement in the house that I'm in, which really sucks because storms are very scary. So I'm going to do Killing Me Softly, which a tornado would probably not kill you softly. I'm just guessing. Last week, your high temperatures for several days were higher than mine. Isn't that weird? It's very, well, I'll tell you, it's very weird. What are duck boots? Well, they say literal duck. They say the word duck on them, but they're basically waterproof boots so that I can, because it's often muddy in the yard. It's definitely muddy wherever Parker is at because he just kind of tramples the ground like farm animals do. So yeah, in fact, we have to move him around a lot because it will get muddy. But yeah, so they're just waterproof boots that I can kick around in the yard when I'm doing like farm type things. Like stall boots. Yeah, exactly. Gotta have some duck boots, gum boots. Exactly. Yeah. Mm-hmm. They're basically farming. Because I'm a farmer, sort of. I have a four-legged farm animal, but it's not the kind that I want. I mean, don't get me wrong, I love Parker and everything, but I don't want a horse. That's what I really want. Robot bought me a goat. I mean, I didn't really ask for a goat, but I have a goat. But I like the goat. I really wanted a horse. I feel like he knew that, but he gave me a goat anyway. That's okay. It's all right. I also didn't want Prim. I didn't want another dog because I get attached to dogs, and then when they get old and die, I get depressed, and I don't ever want to have another dog ever as long as I live because I don't want to have to go through that again. And I had told Robot I never wanted to get another dog ever, and then he went and got her from the local animal shelter, and I just woke up one day and there was this puppy there, and she was very cute, and she fell in love with me, and I fell in love with her, and now we're like peas and carrots, you know, completely inseparable. I'm a lumberjack and it's okay. I work all night and I sleep all day. Okay.
Strumming my pain with his fingers. Singing my life with his words. Killing me softly with his song. Killing me softly with his song, telling my whole life with his words, killing me.
Hold on, what's this chord?
Softly. Softly.
things have like baseball bats for a head.
Yeah, I've had my foot stepped on by a horse before.
Their hooves are, they're pretty heavy. Can't find the dang horse head. Actually, hi, West Sider. I forgot to say hi to you. Big black horse in a cherry tree. Jar of hearts. Actually, I really have to pee. So I'm going to go ahead and take my last break a tiny bit early because I got to pee. I'll be right back, you guys. All right, I'm back. I had to walk Prim. And now Evelyn is walking Audie. She's not having a lot of luck. Oh no, is there a troll in here? Already? I'm not even in here. I wasn't even here to troll. How you trolling if you the streamer's not even here? Thank you, Positively Panda. You're just so positive all the time. You're not a troll. On-screen messages don't get deleted. I'm confused. What do you mean? What? All right, I'm going to do the song. Big black horse and a cherry tree. Nicole, how are you doing? I love this song. What are the chances? What are the chances? I don't know who asked for it. Wait, did you ask for it? Somebody asked for it. I don't even know. Nicole, how are you doing? I haven't seen you in a long time. How have you been? How goes the day? Thank you so much for the biddies. I appreciate it. Thank you, thank you, thank you. You guys should give Nicole a follow because she's very talented. Like, so talented. Crazy good talented. Oops. Unlike me. Unlike moi. Okay. I'm doing pretty good. Thank you for asking.
Heart knows me better than I know myself, so I'm gonna let it do all the talking. Across a place in the middle of nowhere with a big black horse and a cherry tree. Felt a little fear upon my back. I said, don't look back, just keep on walking. When the big black horse said, look this way. I said, hey lady, will you marry me? I said, no, 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 no. I said, no, no, you're not the one for me. And I said, no, 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 no. I said, no, and you're not the one for me. Stopped a dead for a beat or two. But I cut some cord and I shouldn't have done it, and it won't forgive me after all these years. So I sent it to a place in the middle of nowhere with a big black horse and a cherry tree. So happy, and now I've got a home for the world to see. And I said, no. Big black horse and a cherry tree. said no, no. And no, no, and no, 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 no. I said no, you're not the one for me. My heart knows me better than I know myself, so I'm gonna let it do all the talking. Across a place in the middle of nowhere, and a big black horse and a cherry tree. Felt a little fear upon my back. I said, don't look back, just keep on walking. And the big black horse said, look this way. He said, hey lady, will you marry me?
Would have been better if it was up higher. It was a little too low. I couldn't like do anything fancy. It's too low to be fancy. Thank you so much, Nicole. Nicole, do you want to pick a song and I'll sing something for you? You take a look at the queue. Oh, we have Jar of Hearts. Jar of Hearts. Leah likes singing this song. It's a pretty cool song too. I like it also. Have you been streaming very much, Nicole? I did do the Twitch sings. Yeah. I think I did it the first year. I didn't do it the second year. Do you want to know what, wait, are you talking about the contest? Yeah. Yeah, the song that I chose to do was Dream On by Aerosmith, which was very tough. It was really, really hard. Yellow Sky. Okay. I'm going to play... let me play this one real quick for Nicole, you guys. Yeah, I picked the hardest song I could possibly think of to perform. And it was really, really hard. And it took me 3 or 4 days before I could tackle that high note, like the highest high note in that song. You know, the one where he screams. I finally got it. I finally managed to hit the note, but I didn't win or anything. I don't remember who won that first year. And then I was so disheartened that I didn't even enter the contest the second year. It's like, forget it. Because I'd worked so hard on something, which I normally don't. You know, I kind of phone everything in life in general. Okay. So here's one of my songs called Yellow Sky. It's a yellow sky and a storm moving by over. And I know you're afraid, but it's better this way, you said. There's a sun in the sky, yet cold drops fall down. Pour him something more to drink. I've been on his mind. He doesn't care to think, 'cause the words he'll hear were mine. Jesus.
Sun in the sky, yet cold drops fall down. Was there more I could have done?
All right, it's hard to play this guitar. This guitar's too little.
Was it easy for you to leave one? Weatherman calls for rain all year, and all the years of our lives it's a yellow sky and a storm moving by overhead. Better this way, you said. There's a sun in the sky, yet cold drops fall down.
Mostly because they're difficult to play. Thank you so much, Nicole. That one is especially, well, I mean, I wrote it on a bigger guitar, so I'm not contorting my wrist so much to play it on a different guitar. This is just a tiny guitar, so playing it on this one was just hard. Also, I don't know if you noticed, but like instead of playing an A like this, like I would normally play an A, my fingers are hurting so bad because I've streamed and streamed and streamed because Christmas is coming that my fingers just hurt really bad. So it's hard for me to even play like basic chords like an A. So I'm playing it, trying to figure out how to play it, you know, with these fingers, which is not impossible. In fact, I think I will play it moving forward this way. It's just hard. It's just tough right now. I really like Israfel, but my brother wrote the music for this song. Casey, hello, how are you today? Okay, I feel like there was something. Oh, Jar of Hearts, okay. Is the next one in the queue.
Take one more step toward you. Cause all that's waiting is regret. Don't you know I'm not your ghost anymore? You've lost the love I love the most. I learned to live half a life, and now you want me one more time. Who do you think you are, running around leaving scars, collecting your jar of hearts, tearing love apart? You're gonna catch a cold from the ice inside your soul, and don't come back for me. Who do you think you are? Asking all around if I am anywhere to be found. And I have grown too strong to ever fall back in your arms. To live half a life, now you want me one more time. And who do you think you are, running around leaving scars, collecting your jar of hearts, tearing love apart? And you're gonna catch a cold from the ice inside your soul, and don't come back for me. And who do you think you are? Took so just to feel alright. Remember how to put back the light in my eyes. I wish I had missed the first time that we kissed. Back, you don't get to get me back. And who do you think you are, running around leaving scars, collecting your jar of hearts, and tearing love apart? And you're gonna catch a cold the ice inside your soul, and don't come back for me, and don't come back at all. And who do you think you are, running around leaving scars, collecting your jar of hearts, and tearing back for me, and don't come back.
an original from you yet. I've written one song and it's hard and it's definitely not a hit. I don't judge. I admire you for writing. I don't think I've ever written a hit song either. Mostly because I don't really write anything that's very radio friendly. And writing songs is hard. I struggle with writer's block a lot. You're welcome, Panda. Thank you so much. Hi, number six. Thanks for the great show. Makes me want to request a bunch more songs. Internal, thank you so much for the donation. I appreciate it. You go right ahead. I don't know how much longer I'm going to be on, though, to be honest, because I'm getting tired. I'm getting so tired. All right. Man, I feel like a woman. Da, 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 da. How are you doing, number six? Hello, hello, hello. Love potion number six. Let's go, girls. Okay. It's good key. Hi, Julia. Hello. Been lurking. I always enjoy it here. Got to get to bed now, though. Oh, no. Oh, no. Is it bedtime? Oh, Yellow Sky. Actually, I just played it. Yeah. Two songs ago. You were in here. Do you want me to... If you put... Just put a random original in the request. It doesn't matter which one, and I will play you an original. Just not Yellow Sky, because I played it already. Sorry, I need eye drops. Okay. Let's go, girls.
Best thing about being a woman.
goes the day. I wish I was allowed to have a little fun, Sag. A little what? What are you talking about? Feeling the twang in her voice. You mean the twang? I'm losing my voice. That one was really high. Been bouncing. I'll have to request it next time. I don't want to keep you up. Ow. Yeah, I'm being trolled by a primposter. My dog's name is Prim, and there's an imposter in the room, so we call her Primposter. How about we do... Well, I would like to do fancy, but I don't know if my voice can handle it right now. God damn it. What about Voulez-vous coucher avec moi ce soir? Oh, that's probably too high, too. Where's all my soul, sisters? Hey, sister, go, sister, soul, sister, go, sister. What's that song called? Oh, Lady Marmalade. No, I just realized that this and the song I just played are one and the same.
Chocolate, yeah, yeah.
Documentary about Lady Marmalade, and they wanted to give the good parts to Christina, and Pink wasn't having it. Mostly all I remember are the attitude. Oh, well, I mean, if you listen to Pink's part of her of the song, she can barely sing the line she's got. She just doesn't have a lot of... There's not much Pink can do vocally. I mean, don't get me wrong, I like Pink, and I think she's really cool, and I like the tone of her voice, and I think she's a complete and total badass, but she's... Christina Aguilera is a prodigy. She's a vocal prodigy, and you just can't compete with that. But I'll tell you who can top Christina Aguilera on that song, and that's Patti LaBelle, because that technically is a Patti LaBelle song. She recorded it a long time ago, and when they did like the, I guess it was the MTV version, or there was maybe not that. No, I think it was. Anyway, there's a live performance where Patti LaBelle sings the song. And all the girls are there, you know, Maya and Pink and, oh, Kelly Clarkson can really sing, yeah. But Maya's there and Pink is there and Christina Aguilera and Lil' Kim and Patti LaBelle is there. And you think everybody's doing a great job and then Patti LaBelle comes out, was it the Grammys? She comes out and just murders the rest of them. I mean, she doesn't literally murder them. That would be crazy, though. But she vocally murders them all, including Christina. She was phenomenal. And she could hit notes even higher than Christina's high notes in the song. It was crazy. It was really, really cool. It was amazing. I remember that performance and being like, wow, Patti LaBelle. Because she just came in there and owned the stage. These were like little kids, you know. Nancy Kerrigan style. Yes, absolutely. No, no, no. Tanya Harding style. She came in like a wrecking ball.
Came in like a wrecking ball. Never hit so hard in love.
Glad you clarified the murder situation. Can you imagine if Patti LaBelle ran out on stage and just like murdered Christina Aguilera and Maya and Pink and Lil' Kim? That would still be talked about today. That would be insane. All right, I should probably get on out of here. I should probably ease on down the road. Let me do one more song. How about a Christmas song? Since I'm in a Christmassy kind of mood. Very dark. I do watch a lot of true crime, a lot of murder mystery stuff, so I can't help it. I can't help it. Hey, sister, go, sister, soul, sister, go, sister. Get on up. Get on the good foot. Dance till you feel better. Get up off of that thing. Dance till you feel better. How about... gotta be easy because my throat hurts so bad. How about my favorite things? It's not really a Christmas song, but close enough. Is it white woman stuff? It's better to be prepared and know who out there is very dangerous, I feel like. I mean, I feel like watching a lot of true crime stories, which I was reading, like, when I was a kid, they used to have books. Well, they probably still do. But they used to have books that people would write about true crime stories. And I remember the first one that I ever read was... she was a 12-year-old girl that was murdered. Oh, Shanda Scherer was her name, and she was a girl that was murdered here in Kentucky, and her murder was horrifically awful, and there were kids that murdered her, but it was really a terrible story. But I remember being the same, I'm pretty sure I was the same age as her at the time when she died. Well, I mean, I was the same age as her, period. I'm pretty sure she was born in 79, this girl was. But anyway, I remember my mom... they published a book about her story, and my mom gave me this book to read because she wanted me to be aware of how dangerous my friends could potentially be if you've got shit friends, because Shanda Scherer had terrible friends. And so I read this book, and I was hooked on true crime. So way before the YouTube existed, I liked those crime books. They were just interesting to me, just fascinating. But I really like that there's the internet now, you know, and that there are videos, because I can watch all of this stuff about these criminals, and I can kind of learn how their minds work. And one of the things that I really, really, really want to do at some point is I really want to become a private investigator. I would love to get my PI license. It's expensive and I can't do it right now, but I really want to do that, because a lot of towns don't have enough detectives, and a lot of times they will let private investigators help them. So they will share information with them, especially if there's like kids missing and things like that. I would just like to help. I don't want to get a PI license so that I can like bust people for insurance companies. I don't want to do anything like that. Or people who are, you know, checking to see if their spouses are cheating. I don't care about any of that. I just want to help these families who don't have enough, you know, eyes on what's going on in their cases. Those videos with makeup artists talking about horrible true crime stories. I don't know why I do that to myself. Bailey Sarian is the best one, I think. I love Bailey Sarian. Also, she's really good at makeup. I bet you know exactly who that is. I like the makeup too. Yeah, I like the makeup too. Freelance cold case private detective. Yes, that's what I would like to do. Yeah, I would never charge for it. I'll stick to sci-fi. Well, I like sci-fi too. Don't get me wrong. It puts the lotion on the skin. Some of these stories are insane. They're crazy. I mean, the stories are just so out there that you wouldn't believe that they were true. Some of these stories are just batshit crazy. And I don't know why I'm interested in it. I just always have been. But, I mean, here's the thing.
Hold on. Give me a second
to collect my thoughts. I feel like as a woman, the world is dangerous, and it's really important to have some kind of idea about what those dangers are. And for me, I feel like it's educational, you know? We have so many different interests and feelings. We do. I really think makeup and murder is a good combo, though. I don't know.
I'm kind of all over the place as far as my interests go, because I don't know. That's just one of them. That's one of the things. Chord. Where'd I put my capo? There it is. Hi, Zuckerburgers. Hi, how are you doing? Thank you for the host a while ago. Sorry, I got busy talking about murder. You know, awesome stuff like murder. I've even covered true crime stories on this channel before. I've talked about some, but I actually did a true crime stream one time. I didn't do it anymore after that because I got so nervous without having my shield, which is this thing, in front of me, and having it just be me talking. It just was too scary, and I just couldn't do it. So that's why I haven't done it. I have also done a makeup stream, not at the same time though.
Drops on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper.
Have you guys noticed I can't talk today? Bright copper? What? Let's try it here.
Drops on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favorite things. Green colored ponies and crisp apple strudels, doorbells and sleigh bells and schnitzel with noodles, wild geese that fly with the moon on their wings. These are a few of my favorite things. Girls in dresses with blue satin sashes, snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes, silver white winters that melt into spring. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm
Thank you so much, Bright Star. It was fun. Today was fun.
I had fun. Did you guys have fun? I mean, did everybody else have fun too? We're out, man. So tired.
Not as tired as I am sometimes on stream, though. Like, I feel like I've had some rest.
Thank you guys so much. Let me see who's on real quick that we can go raid. It's getting chilly. It's getting cold.
Oh, it's only 2 o'clock in the morning. No wonder I'm not that tired. Lately, I've been streaming till like way later, so. My stomach's not growling. You guys are imagining that.
And then I don't feel so bad.
Let's go raid. Let's go raid Lexi Lynn. She is playing guitar. Sunday night acoustic songs. Yeah, let's go raid her. She is playing music. You guys seem to like that kind of thing.
Bye, Nicole. It was good to see you. Have a great night, day, everybody. You guys have a good day, night also.
And don't forget, Santa is watching you. So be on your best behavior. He knows when you are sleeping and he knows when you're awake. He knows all the other things that you do too. That even you, your mother doesn't know. So I'm just saying, you guys, be good. Be nice. 'Tis the season or something. Worship Santa. I don't know. Whatever it is you do. Or not, you know. If you don't want to. All right. Bye, you guys. Santa's a little creepy. Yeah, he's kind of a stalker. But he brings presents, so it's okay. Bye, you guys. See you later.